It's Emily with Hearty Soul. Welcome back to the channel. It's great to see you back. Last week, I sent out a message on Instagram and Facebook asking how many people would want to learn how to sew and what kind of things would you want to learn when it comes to sewing your machine and what kind of projects you wanted to learn. And a lot of you responded. I was a little bit surprised. A lot of you responded saying, I bought a machine over quarantine time to make some masks and I just learned just enough to make masks. Or maybe it was, I bought the machine, I was so intimidated about the sewing machine that I put it in the closet and I haven't used it since. And I want to change all of that for you today. So today I'm gonna go over a few simple essentials when it comes to sewing, a little bit about the cost of things and what it takes to just sort of get started with this really awesome hobby. Some of you said, I want to learn how to sew a pouch with a zipper. Some of you said, I want to learn how to make curtains for my house. One of you said, I want to learn how to make pillow cushions or a pillow cover. I've got tutorials on how to make aprons, how to make a bow tie, how to make a simple skirt, how to sew your own tank top. There's so many things that you can learn when it comes to sewing that I just am so excited that you are starting this journey with me. And at any time, if you've got questions or concerns or comments, leave those down below before this series really gets rolling so I know exactly how I can help you on your sewing journey. So today we're gonna go over some essentials when it comes to sewing. And it really starts out with a sewing machine. Now, you can sew. Of course, you can hand sew all you want, but if we're talking about making major projects, we will need to start with the sewing machine. So this sewing machine, it is a Viking Husqvarna. I got it when I was 18 years old, and so I've been sewing a long time, and it is a little bit more of a spendier machine. I came from a specialty sewing shop. And I love it. I've had to do very little maintenance on it. It's super easy to use. It's not computerized. I really like that it's not computerized because computerized machines have a tendency, if one thing goes down, then the entire machine goes down. Whereas if something happens to this machine, it's a little bit easier to figure out what's going on and you're not having to take apart a motherboard and that kind of thing. I do take this in for yearly maintenance because I do use my sewing machine a lot. And just like anything else, you want to make sure that your machine is maintained, well oiled, the light bulb is checked and working, and all of the different parts are able to be working. And especially, it's good to have it cleaned out. So during those annual maintenances, they will clean out my machine and make sure that there's no fuzz or lint built up in the machine that will prevent it from working properly. Okay, so you can get into a sewing machine for as little as $80. You could probably go to Walmart and buy a Brother sewing machine for $80. I'll link something similar to what I have down below here and in the list of essentials. You can get fancy and have something computerized. However, it's just my preference that I like something not computerized. Something I can manipulate easy enough and I can see all of the parts, I know how it operates, and I don't need to have a degree in technology in order to run my machine. Okay, so the next thing you're going to want to have when you're starting sewing projects is an iron. And many of you may have an iron already. Mine is very old and I don't even know, it's probably from the 80s, but I love it because it gets really, really hot. And there's probably some sort of like heat limitations on irons right now, or some sort of like, I don't know, energy efficiency laws that come into play when it comes to machines or safety requirements or something. Anyway, this machine is old, but it gets super hot, and I love that. I've had newer machines, newer irons that don't get hot. So you're gonna want an iron just to press seams, to open up hems, and that kind of thing. So an iron is on the list. You don't already have one. We don't do a lot of ironing around here unless it's super special or super wrinkled, but I do use my iron a lot more for sewing projects. Okay, the second thing you're gonna need is a tape measure. So I have just a super inexpensive tape measure. I think this was like $2 at Walmart at the time. I actually have two tape measures. I keep one just in my drawer of sewing things to measure when I'm cutting out my fabric. And then I also have one that is fixed right to my sewing table. Okay, so once we've got an iron and a tape measure, the next thing you're going to need is some sewing scissors. Now you could go inexpensive, or you could go with genuine lifetime, going to last you forever kind of quality of sewing scissors. Now, I was lucky enough to be gifted this when I graduated from college. So I have a theater minor, and I did a lot of costume design in college, and a very special professor assistant gifted me these. We used a lot of Ginger sewing scissors when I was designing costumes in college and doing a lot of work in the costume shop. And so this is a very high quality scissors. It's not inexpensive, but I will link it below. It has been the only scissors I've ever used in, 15 years. So I've had it a really long time. I do have it sharpened occasionally, but it is held up. It is so nice. You could do a Fiskars. Fiskars is just fine. Just know that it may or may not last a lifetime. And in my world, I love something that's going to maybe be a little bit more high end, but I know that it's gonna last me a long time. That's important to me. So it came, the little set that I got for my college graduation gift came with a big one with a cover like this. And then it also had a smaller one like this, which is super handy for like snipping seams, snipping small threads, and just clipping really tight, nice pieces. So first I'll talk about pins. You'll want to get a little case of pins. I don't use pins a lot anymore. I used to use pins a lot when I was first starting out sewing, but I've gotten pretty good at just folding over my seams and knowing exactly where things need to go and being able to have the hand positioning to know how to hold the fabric so that it's not going to slip away from the seams. So I don't use a lot of pins anymore, but it's very nice to have pins on hand, and I do use them for an occasional project or for when I need to pin in a zipper or different things like that. So you'll definitely need some pins. I also keep some hand threading needles around. Again, I'll link all of these things below so you'll have everything that I do in order to get starting with sewing. The other thing that I've just recently started using in the last few years are these little clips. They're super nice. They're very strong, and they have a little measuring label right on them. So you can tell if you've got them in a 1/4 inch or 5/8 inch, which is super handy. So these little clips are not cheap, however, and I've just started using them when I'm like rolling a hem or that kind of thing. And they're just sort of really handy alternative to pins. Okay, the next thing you're going to need is thread. When it comes to thread, you could get really fancy, or you could just go with an all-purpose poly thread, which is what I do. I just get my thread at Joann Fabric or Walmart, wherever I happen to be and be needing thread at the same time. I really like just a natural color thread for all of my projects, unless I'm doing something dark, navy or black. Then I also keep a black and also a navy thread on hand. Of course, you could get all sorts of colors of thread to match the project fabric that you're using, but I just really love sticking with a natural color thread for everything. Maybe when you're first starting out, you want to be able to match the thread to the fabric so that you don't see any stitching mistakes as you go through. This might come as a shock to you, but as a new sewer, you will be making stitching mistakes. That's just part of learning. I make stitching mistakes all of the time, and I just think that's part of the character of the piece and the fact that this piece was not created by a machine and rather a human, and I think that's just valuable in and of itself. So I'm not worried about stitching mistakes, but if you are, you could get a thread that matches your fabric. Again, I just go with a natural color, kind of like an off-white or an ivory color for most all of my projects. Then you're going to need some bobbins. Now your machine might come with bobbins. My machine's bobbins have a D on one side of the bobbin, and that is representative of what needs to go at the top. So the D needs to be at the top, not at the bottom of my machine. So next week we're gonna go through how to thread a machine and we'll talk about bobbins a little bit more. But if you don't have bobbins with your machine, you're going to want to figure out in your manual or your instructions, you'll find what type of bobbins go in your machine. So you're going to want to get a few bobbins so that you can thread up maybe a natural color or a white, and then maybe a black or a navy on the other bobbins. Other thing that you're going to need as a new sewer is a seam ripper. Now I have gone through several different seam rippers. Seam ripper is for tearing out mistakes and starting all over again. Again, I use this almost every project just because it happens, but it's just something that you'll want to be able to keep in your drawer of sewing goods. So the last thing on my essential sewing list is sewing needles. So this is the needle that goes into your sewing machine that sews as you put projects through it. Your machine might have a specific needle that is required for using it. What is really convenient is that they have these universal needles that I just pick up in like a 3-pack at Walmart or Joann Fabric. I just grab a whole bunch because as I'm working with a lot of leather or denim, anything kind of tough or rough, you will break needles, and it is the last thing you want to have to worry about when you're in the middle of a project, especially if you live in the country like we do, where there is not a sewing shop around very close and you want to be able to finish your project. So I encourage you just to grab a few packs of these and stick them in your drawer. They're not very expensive, but that way you're always got a fresh needle if you break one during one of your projects. And these kind of needles are special because, at least in my machine, they have a flat back, and that flat back always has to face back on my machine. And again, we're gonna go over that next week when we talk about how to thread your sewing machine. They do have specific needles intended for denim or leather. I wouldn't worry about that just too much unless you're getting into that world. Need a special machine for that anyhow, but I just find by just using a general universal needle, I can accomplish most every project that I get in. So that's it for this week. That is the essential list of sewing supplies that you'll need in order to get started with this brand new hobby that you are starting here. Thank you so much for joining me this week while we go through the essential list of sewing supplies that you will need. Next week, we will talk about how to thread your machine and get started. Thanks so much for joining me. Have a great week.